Take a diagonal section at the front hairline, combing out from the head and cut from short to long so that the shortest length falls at or just below the chin. Angle this cutting line to maintain length at the longest point. Repeat on the other side and check for balance. Continue working towards the back of the head in this manner, over-directing each section to the cutting line. Work from side to side until hair from the back no longer reaches the cutting line. And now to cut the line, section the hair from the hairline to the nape down the center or following the natural parting. In this case, I have followed the model's natural parting. At the nape, take slight diagonal sections and comb the hair down with little tension. Holding the hair between your fingers, with as little elevation as possible, cut a horizontal line. Keep the length below the shoulders for a longer look. Work your way up the back, always cutting to the guide. When you reach the top of the ears, incorporate the sides. The side sections are combed down from the base, then over-directed toward the back and cut to the horizontal line. This will maintain length at the sides. Repeat on each side until you reach the top of the head. And now for the interior layers. Starting at the back, take a vertical section and lift up from the head, letting the hair at the occipital fall out. Cut from short to long, from crown to occipital, keeping the cutting line angled to maintain strength at the perimeter. Continue onto the sides with pivoting sections. Cut from short to long, keeping the cutting line angled to maintain length at the sides and toward the front. The hair below the rounds of the head should fall out so that you don't cut the line that you already established. And now to style the melting layers haircut. Dry the hair 80 to 90% using medium heat and your hands. Using a paddle brush, begin at the nape and work with 1-inch thick sections. Place the bristle side of the paddle brush against the hair at the base. Rotate the brush so that the bristles face up. This will allow for some tension. Ensuring that the blow dryer nozzle is pointing down the hair shaft, move the dryer and brush slowly towards the ends of the hair without touching the hair with the nozzle. Repeat until each section is thoroughly dry before moving on to the next. Take vertical sections and lightly mist with Style Sign Sleek Perfection. Using a flat iron, create a curl from the mid shaft to ends. Continue curling around the head. Use your fingers to comb the set out. Use StyleSign Big Finish Volume Hairspray for strong hold as well as humidity and color protection.